children, this video is in continuity with the previous video of the chapter Human Health and Diseases. The various objectives we are going to cover in this video are communicable diseases caused by protozoans such as malaria, its causes, mode of infection, symptoms, prevention and control including the life cycle of Plasmodium, amoebic dysentery, its causes, mode of infection and symptoms. So first of all, talking about malaria. Though this disease is known for a long time, the name malaria was given by the Romans, who associated it with foul, a bad air of the swamp and marshes, where mosquitoes bred in large numbers and killed millions of people. The cause behind malaria is Plasmodium, and Plasmodium is a single cell tiny organism from the group Protozoa. There are four species of Plasmodium that cause malaria. All have almost a similar life cycle and the same mode of spread. Different species of Plasmodium are responsible for different types of malaria. So here in this table, first of all, the species of Plasmodium, it is Plasmodium ovale. It causes malaria, which is mild tertian malaria. It results in high fever after every 48 hours. Talking about distribution, it is prevalent in West Africa and South America. Next is Plasmodium vivax. It causes benign tertian malaria, which results in high fever after every 48 hours, and it is found in both tropical and temperate zones. Third is Plasmodium malariae. It causes quassia malaria that causes high fever after every 72 hours. It is most prevalent in tropical and temperate zones. Last, which is the most violent strain, that is Plasmodium falciparum, deadly tertian malaria. Fever with irregular pattern any time between 24 to 48 hours, and it is common in tropics. Now talking about the mode of infection. Malaria is spread by the bite of female Anopheles mosquito, which feeds on human blood. The male Anopheles mosquito feeds on fruit juices, or we can say plant juices, so is harmless. Female Anopheles mosquito transmits the malarial parasite from an infected person to a healthy person and acts as a carrier or vector of the disease. Talking about Plasmodium, the malarial parasite, it spends a part of its life cycle in female Anopheles mosquito in its salivary gland. So primary host is female Anopheles mosquito. Monkeys act as a reservoir host. That is, they may carry Plasmodium but do not suffer themselves. So malaria can spread by female Anopheles mosquito carrying the parasite from monkey to man also. So we'll be discussing about the life cycle of Plasmodium. Here in this case, the malarial parasite, that is Plasmodium, how it enters the human body. It is by the bite of infected female Anopheles mosquito. When it bites the human, it injects saliva to prevent coagulation of blood. This results in transfer of parasites in the human body in the form of sporozoites. These sporozoites, they enter the liver cells, and over here they increase in number by reproducing asexually. After that, due to bursting of liver cells, the sporozoites, they are released in the blood cell, and at this stage they are known as merozoites. These merozoites, they enter the RBC and form a ring-shaped structure called trophozoites. These trophozoites, they can increase in number either asexually or sexually. Talking about the asexual cycle, here again they'll result in the production of merozoites, which will be released due to exponential increase in the merozoites. The RBCs will burst, the merozoites are released in the blood, again they will increase exponentially, and this way the cycle continues. And if I talk about the sexual production, there these trophozoites, they result in the production of gametocytes, that are the germ cells of Plasmodium. These germ cells, they are transferred into the uninfected mosquito. Again, how? When the uninfected, that mosquito, bites the human beings, along with the blood, these gametocytes enter the mosquito. And finally, Here, the male and female gametocytes, they fuse to form a zygote. This zygote, it develops into oocyst in the gut of mosquito. Now, this oocyst reaches the salivary glands. Over there, the oocyst releases sporozooids. Now, they are there in the salivary glands of female anopheles mosquitoes. Ultimately, this mosquito, when bites another healthy human being, again these sporozooids will enter inside. So there are primarily two hosts. One, that is the primary host, mosquito, female anopheles mosquito, and the secondary host is human being. Now, talking about the various symptoms. So here in this picture, we can see headache, fatigue, nausea, chills, fever, muscle ache and vomiting. So we'll be discussing about symptoms in detail. Each malarial attack lasts for about 6 to 10 hours and the patient goes through three stages. That is cold stage, hot stage and sweating stage. Cold stage, where malaria begins with very cold and recurrence shivering chills, there is a gradual rise in temperature. Hot stage, next is high temperature up to 104 degree Fahrenheit, accompanied by headache and severe body ache. It also leads to faster respiration and heartbeat. Sweating stage, the fever may subside on its own after about 3 to 4 hours and come to normal stage. It is followed by profuse sweating. If malaria is not treated, the above symptoms appear again. The fever may come after a gap of 24, 48 or 72 hours at the same time. Malaria leaves the patient quite weak and anemic. After the patient is cured, it takes some time for the person to come back to normal health. Malaria may also lead to enlargement of spleen and liver. If not cured properly, it may also cause kidney failure, mental confusion and even death. Malaria can be diagnosed by the blood smear test taken during fever. So, talking about the prevention tips. Prevention. Malaria is a communicable disease. That is, it is infectious and spread from an infected person to a healthy person by the bite of female anopheles mosquito. The only way to prevent malaria is to prevent the mosquitoes from biting and even by destroying their breeding places. A fine net or wire gauze should be used on doors and windows to prevent the entry of mosquitoes. Insect repellent creams like Odomos also helps in keeping mosquitoes away. Sleeping under fine mesh mosquito nets help to prevent mosquito bites. Adult mosquitoes can be killed by spraying insecticides like DDT. A mosquito larva can be destroyed by spraying kerosene oil in open drains, stagnant water bodies, puddles and ponds, and even by adding few drops of kerosene oil in water of water cooler as well. Another effective means to kill mosquito larva is to introduce fish like Gambusia minnows and the trouts that feed on mosquito larva in large water bodies. Above all, we should not allow the stagnant water around our houses as it is a breeding place for the female anopheles mosquitoes. So here in this picture, we are summarizing the prevention methods, use of a mosquito net, mosquito repellent, then paying special attention to children, then knowing about the symptoms of malaria, wearing long sleeve clothing and keeping our homes clean. Next, talking about the control and elimination of malaria. Malaria can be controlled by taking the drug quinine in prescribed doses. Quinine is extracted from the bark of cinchona tree. Malarial parasite has become resistant to this drug due to overprescription and overdose taken by the people. Nowadays, malaria is being treated by other medicines like chloroquine and sulfadoxin. The research is on to develop a vaccine for malaria. Now, next we'll be discussing about amoebic dysentery, that is amoebiasis, the various symptoms, causes of amoebic dysentery. So, the cause. Amoebiasis, also called amoebic dysentery, is caused by a parasite that is Ent amoeba histolytica. It is a parasite in the colon part of the large intestine of man. Talking about the mode of infection, the infection spreads through the cyst from the feces of infected person. The cyst reach a healthy person through contaminated food and water. Houseflies act as mechanical carriers and serve to transmit the parasite from the feces of infected person to food and food products, thereby contaminating them. Ant amoeba develop the cyst as they pass out into the feces. These cysts can live in dry, unfavorable conditions outside the body for a long time. And when such cysts are ingested, their walls dissolve and new infection begins. In this picture, we can see how it is transmitted through infected water. The various symptoms of amoebiasis or amoebic dysentery. As a parasite feeds on the tissues of the intestine and secretes a tissue dissolving enzyme, there may be ulceration of the colon. It results in mild diarrhea, alternating with constipation, abdominal pain, and cramps. Stool contains large amount of slimy mucus, and in acute cases, there may be traces of blood also. Amoebiasis is widespread in various countries, especially in places that have poor sanitary conditions and unsafe drinking water. And in chronic cases, the parasites may bore into the intestine and are carried to liver where they cause serious damage to the capillary walls. The various signs and symptoms include abdominal tenderness, bloody stools, that is fecal matter, fever, vomiting. The basic treatment is a combination of antibiotic and amoebicidal medication can be given, and certain drugs like metronidazole can be given for the treatment of amoebic dysentery. So thank you so much. We'll be continuing in the next video.